Hello, Mohawk. Welcome to another edition. We're going to be bringing you the game today with Mohawk women's volleyball team facing off against Boreal College. I'm Nick Sahami. So yesterday was quite the game. It was a big one, another win for your Mohawk team. They're now 3-2 on the year, bumping up over 500. Should have a close one today, but we'll see. As could be a bit of an easy one for Mohawk, as Boreal are actually 0-6 on the year. But again, you don't want to say it's going to be too easy too soon.
Yeah, for sure. No underdogs out there for sure.
Okay, so as mentioned, we have your Mohawk women's volleyball team facing off against Boreal College today. Should be a good one. Have quite a few veterans on your Mohawk side. You have Kristen Bielachowski, of course, Yvonne Mann, some key veterans that have really... 3-2 for Mohawk as they took that win yesterday against Cambrian College at the D-Bark as well. Today's game, 1 p.m. start coming at you very soon here. And Boreal, as mentioned, they are 0-6 on the year, so they're definitely going to be looking to hit that win column. This will be their second away game, as they've had an early start at home for their first few games, but unfortunately still couldn't use that to their advantage. Mohawk on the other side, with that win yesterday, are now 3-2, bumping up over 500. And we're going to have a good one today, as we have your starting lineup now on the floor for both Mohawk and Boreal College. And as Boreal is ready to set it up here, as mentioned, some of your key players, the highlight today are going to be, of course, Natalie Pizarwa. And on the floor to start, we're going to have Yvonne Mann, Amanda Kuiper, Kinsley Child, Jess Namarmo, and Alessandra Asaf. And with this set there, number 16 for Boreal, gets it back over. Yvonne Mann gets it back. They set it up here on the Boreal side. Great dig out there for Mohawk, but unfortunately it will be out. First point going to Boreal College. And on the Boreal side, we now have Christine Boldreau setting it up again here on serve. Joining her on the floor is Audrey Ann Sosie, Emily Goulet, Courtney Phillips. And serves up. Mohawk gets it out there from Alessandra Asaf. Yvonne Mann gets it back over again. Return there from Boreal with the spike. And it's going to be a fault there, so it will be point to Mohawk. So Josh, yesterday was quite the good game, I hear. It was pretty action-packed. Close one in the first couple sets.
Yeah, it sure was, Nick. This Cambrian yesterday loves keeping the games close, and so does Mohawk, as we are tied at one here. Another close one here. For sure, it was definitely a great match, but Mohawk did come out on top 3-1 then that one.
Awesome, great dig there. Asaf gets it back over.
Looks like the refs called a double hit there.
And it'll be Mohawk with the 2-1 lead. Starting out here early on, Yvonne Mann will be setting up for the serve. And as she gets it over.
Yvonne Mann, a very clutch server, Nick, for sure.
Perfect. They're going to call that one out, and it will be Mohawk with the quick 3-1 lead here. Yvonne Mann sets it up again here for a serve. And as she gets it there, that will be the ace on that serve. Quick start here for Mohawk now as they jump out to the 4-1 lead. Yvonne Mann over again. As Boreal set it up here for the spike. Great.
Oh, just over that double block from Kipper, or Kuiper, sorry, and Bielachowski.
So as Boreal managed to capture that point there, it's now 4-2 as they set it up for serve. And just for the audience members to recognize here, we will be a little more verbal on the scores here as we are having some technical difficulties on this graphic side. So you'll be hearing me and Josh announce that score just a little more.
Kuiper right there.
And as Josh touched upon, a great kill there from Kuiper.
Nick, today we got to look out for Mann and Kuiper with a dynamic duo there, as well as Bielachowski in there as well.
Jesse Marmo with the set. Serves it up. And they're going to say that one was out of bounds there. So it'll be Boreal setting up for serve here. Number 13, Emily Goulet. 5-3 now for your Mohawk Mountaineers. Serve is up. And into the net there. Easy point there for Mohawk. As they jump back up now here to 6-3. We'll have number 13, Kirsten Bielichowski with the serve here. Big, powerful serve. She really uses that 5'11 height to her advantage out there. She gets it out there. Von Mann with the great dig on the back line as they get it over. Boreal set it up here for the spike. Another good dig there by Bielichowski. And Mohawk with the big spike there.
Wow, Kinsley Child with a beautiful smash there. That was good to see.
Yeah, Kinsley Child, she's definitely been one of their top hitters there.
Yeah, for sure. 1.45 kills per set average on the year so far.
Yep. Bielichowski again with the serve. Back here from Boreal.
Great dig there, Jess Navarro.
The tip over there. Boreal getting it back out again here for another setup. But unfortunately, that spike right into the middle of the net there. And that'll put the score up to 8-3 for your Mohawk Mountaineers. As Kirsten Bielichowski sets up for the serve on the back line again here. Up and over.
Beautiful float serve there.
And Boreal trying to keep it in. They do get it over there. But they're going to say
outside the antenna there for sure.
And with that fault, it's going to be Mohawk up 9-3. Bielichowski again with another serve here. Great placement on that one. But it's just going to be out of bounds there. So that'll put the serve back over to Boreal's side. 9-4 here. Number 15, Emily Goulet, setting up now. She gets it over. Great dig out there from Bielichowski. Little action at the net right there. And they're going to say it was Boreal's point.
Net violation there, yeah. Boreal's point. Emily Goulet back for the serve. Second consecutive serve.
So 9-5 here still for your Mohawk Mountaineers. Goulet up with the serve. She gets it over. Great overhead pass there into the spike. Nice play there. Kuiper with a big play.
And Nick, that was the duo we were talking about earlier. That is the one that Boreal really needs to look out for if they're going to have any chance to beat Mohawk today.
Kuiper now setting up for the serve as well. Up and over. Just gets it over there. Boreal with the return. And we're going to get Mohawk with the point there as it was out of bounds there on Boreal. That'll put it at 11-5 here. We have Amanda Kuiper now here with the serve again. Up and over. Good placement there. And with the ace, Amanda Kuiper. A couple of aces here early on for your Mohawk Mountaineers. So we have a substitution there, but Kuiper up again with the serve. A dig out there from Boreal as they get it up here.
And they do that with the back row, trying to get it into deep.
Big one there from Kinsley Child again. As you touched upon, Josh, he seems to have some power coming from that position right there.
Yeah, for sure. Kinsley Child is definitely a good asset, and it just shows the depth of the bench for Mohawk here.
Kuiper up again with the serve. Dig out from Goulet on the back. Boreal gets it over. Asaf digs it out there. Kuiper, unfortunately, they're going to call the net violation on Mohawk. It'll be point Boreal. And that puts the score at 13-6. Serves up. Mohawk digs it out there. Kuiper gets it over. And it's going to be out of bounds as Yvonne Mann went for a big kill there, but unfortunately could not keep it in. Boreal with the serve back over here. Bielichowski gets it. Kuiper puts it up. And Pizarro could not keep it in there, but that was a pretty solid play, though. Mohawk definitely coming out pretty strong here with their returns. But as Boreal sets it up here for the serve, it's a 13-8 lead for Mohawk. Little tip over there by Pizarro. Little nifty. But Boreal caught that as they get it back. Mann digs it out there, gets it to Kuiper. Kuiper up over with Lynn Kinsley-Child, but she couldn't finish there. Great play, but unfortunately she was just a little low on that spike. So it'll be Boreal point. 13-9 lead here for your Mohawk Mountaineers as we get a timeout.
So Nick, if you were matching right now, what are you telling the Mountaineers to get them through this first set?
Well, they've definitely been up and down a little bit. They've seemed to take control of the play pretty consistently for a few points there. Bialachowski was very strong with a few serves there. So what I would say is just try to keep it consistent. You know, they're bouncing around a little bit. Boreal's obviously, you know, trying to keep it close here. You know, the lead slipped a little bit there. It was almost doubled, you know, almost doubled up for Mohawk, but now we're bringing it back. It's only a four-point lead. So what I would say if I was Matthew Schnarr over there in the huddle, I'd be saying, make sure you guys keep playing consistently. Get those spikes down. Your returns are there. Just got to make sure they're in bounds.
Yeah, I totally agree, Nick. And eliminating unforced errors is what is very key in volleyball. Eliminating those missed serves and those trying to do too much sets is what's going to be the difference maker between Mohawk and Boreal today.
You definitely touched upon a point there. They did have a couple of faults there at the net, so if they could be a little more careful there, obviously, that will, of course, lead to some more success. But you touched upon that. We're going to be coming back here with Boreal, number 12, Brianne Chouinard, with the serve up. A dig out there. A little tip over by Kinsley-Child. Not only does she have the power, she has the niftiness. Boreal does save that, gets it back over, though. Kuiper up again as Pizarro puts away that spike. That was a big one there as Mohawk comes out of the huddle very strong. And we'll have a 14-9 lead here as we get Kinsley-Child setting up for the serve. Serve is up from Child.
Beautiful float slash jump serve there from Kinsley-Child.
Spike there, dig out from Child there. Ooh, almost. It was just on the net there as Kuiper tried to save it, but they will call the fault on that. Point over to Boreal. As we get number 9, Melanie Ledger setting up here for the serve. Unfortunately, into the net there for Boreal, but fortunately for Mohawk, they'll take the point there, 15-10, and Pizarro will set up on the end line here for the serve.
Kinsley-Child coming back into the game there.
Very quick break for her, and she's back in. Pizarro with the serve up. Boreal digs it out, sets up for a spike there. A bit of a miss hit on that one, and it's going to work out in Mohawk's favor there as they snag the point on that one. Pizarro back on the end line here for the serve. Up and over. Chouinard there with the dig out over to Phillips as Boreal gets it over.
Child up. Great pass there.
Boom! That was a big one. It was out of bounds, but Mohawk is still trying to get those big power kills in. As you saw here, Bialachowski, she can really use that 5'11 height to get up there.
Yeah, fourth year vet, captain of this squad, Nick, for sure is going to be a leader out there for Mohawk.
Boudreau with the serve for Boreal into the net. And that will be point Mohawk.
17-11 Mountaineers here.
Mann setting up for the serve here for your Mohawk Mountaineers. Up and over. A dig up from Phillips. Nice
there.
Little tip there, but won't work as it's going to be the point for Mohawk. But it was a nifty play, and as it seems, Boreal maybe trying to switch it up a little bit with that big front line there from Mohawk. Definitely stopping a lot of their power plays. But Mann up again, dig out there. Boreal gets it over, a bit of a deflection on that block. Back over to Kuiper, big block there from Boreal as they save it there and they set up for their own. Hit there, but nice little save there from Mann as we unfortunately couldn't get up over there from Jess DeMarmo, so it'd be point Boreal. But that was a pretty good rally we had there, actually. Quite a few hits back and forth, Josh. I'd say that was probably one of the bigger rallies we've had so far.
Yeah, for sure, Nick. A lot of unforced errors here and a little bit of mistakes. Happens early on in first sets, but as the Mountaineers and everyone settles in, get some more excitement.
I was sorry to interrupt there, Josh. Almost a couple of good digs there from Asaf and Kuiper, but unfortunately Mohawk couldn't save it as we have. We have number 4 here, Haley Vervel, setting it up for the serve for Boreal. She gets it up and over. A bit of a powerful serve there, actually.
Mann to Kuiper there. Perfect.
They definitely have. They're in each other's heads, it seems. Good dig out there from Mohawk. Back over to Kuiper. A little flip over. A great dig out there from Boreal. As we're going to get a fault at the net here on Boreal, it will be point Mohawk. But I just want to highlight, that was a great dig from Boldrow there.
Jessna Marmo sets up for the serve here. Beautiful jump serve there from Marmo.
Chouinard kicks it back at the end line there. A setup for that big serve, but big block there. But couldn't keep that block in as it will be point Mohawk.
Big swing there from Bielachowski there, Nick.
Yeah, she gets up there. But good play for Mohawk so far here as we have Jessna Marmo setting up again here for the serve.
Jessna Marmo, the Cambridge native.
Return there. Kuiper getting up for another little tip as Mohawk sets it up here again. Couldn't get in position in time as they just get it over. But for Mohawk there, Boreal couldn't set up themselves as unfortunately Brianne Chouinard couldn't get it over there. It'll be point Mohawk. Marmo setting up again here for the serve. 21-13 here, Mohawk, as they're coming up on the first point here in the match. Over it goes. Dig out from Boreal. They get it over. Man with a nice dig herself. Child with a great hit there, but on that back line. Boudreau with a good dig for Boreal. As they get it in there, it's going to be point Boreal.
Yeah, huge kill there from Emily Goulette. Averages around 1.38 kills per set this year so far.
So Stephanie Sicard here with the serve in for Boreal. Child on the back line, took the return, got the set up there, got it over. Boreal easily handled that one as they get it back, and it's going to be out of bounds there, point Mohawk.
Quick substitution here.
As we've got a couple of substitutions here, we'll see Natalie Preserwa in for Asaf. And we'll see Rebecca Powell in for the first time as she will be replacing Kristen Bielachowski. And we have Powell on the end line here for the serve as well. And that's 22-14 for your Mountaineers. She gets it over. Miss hit from Boreal, but they do manage to recover and get it over. Set up here. Pizarro with a big spike down there. Big point for Mohawk.
Beautiful setup there by Mann.
Yes, Pizarro, she's definitely one of their stronger hitters as well, too. Not on the level of Bielachowski or Mann, but very strong for Mohawk.
Yeah, her average is a little bit lower, but she did come into this one with 13 kills on the year.
Great dig from Mann as they set up Kuiper over to Child. Big block there, but they're going to call the point for Boreal as it looked like it was a net violation there on Mohawk. So that'll put the score at 23-15 as you'll see Emily Goulette setting up for the serve here for Boreal. Gets it up and over. Dig out there by Asaf. Man over to Preserwa. Another dig out on the other end for Boreal as they get it up. Little nifty play at the net there for Preserwa. But Boreal with a spike there as Asaf couldn't handle that on the back line. So now 23-16 for Boreal as Mohawk trying to finish it out here. Finding these last couple of points a little tougher. But Emily Goulette with the serve here. Up and over for Boreal. Dig out there for Asaf. Kuiper with the hit. They're going to call a net violation there, so we'll see. Point over for Mohawk. And Kuiper will set it up here for the serve. As Mohawk here, 24-16, 1 point away from that first point. Dig out there from Goulette, though. Goulette gets it back here, and it's going to be out of bounds.
And your Mountaineers will take the first set, 25-16. Great effort there by the Mountaineers.
Yes, that was definitely a good first game there. You'll notice Bielachowski, she's definitely putting on a performance again, it seems. And of course, Yvonne Mann's another strong one there, and Amanda Kuiper. That front line is super, super strong. They use their height to their advantage here for Mohawk.
Yeah, but the veteran presence there for Mohawk definitely helps them and is critical for their success there as they dominated Boreal in the first set there.
So we're going to be joined though by Ryla Weir very shortly here as we'll get a little bit more insights into the game. Sorry about that, guys. We're just having a little bit of technical difficulties there as we figure things out. But we'll definitely highlight a couple of key things here. Obviously, yesterday's game, Josh mentioned there was some big play from Bialikowski.
And yeah, as well as that man-Kuiper duo was going really well. We're going to be looking at some highlight packs here in just a moment. But let's talk about that man duo, or man Kuiper duo here in the first set. See if we can get a few highlights of that.
So you'll see there, that was one of the key aces from the Mohawk Mountaineers as they started. Another ace right there as well, too, from Amanda Kuiper. Some strong serving from Mohawk. They definitely made the returns a little difficult there, as you see Kuiper with a big kill there.
But there's that setup again, Nick. Not only is man setting up people, but so is Kuiper. It's what's critical for the Mohawk's success here.
Yeah, you saw in that last one, Kuiper to Pizarro, actually. So, you know, she has the hops herself to get up there, but she has the touch as well on those sets. So.
Yeah, it really just shows you the depth of the Mohawk bench here, and that maybe not all their starters are playing today, but that doesn't matter. We're still going to take it to Boreal as hard as we can.
Well, yeah, you mentioned Bialikowski, you know, 5'11", man, 5'7", Kuiper, 5'7". Like, there's a lot of height there. And if you look at the front line for Boreal, I think that's where they're seeing a lot of the struggles. You know, some of their key players, you know, they have a couple like Emily Goulet, who might be, I think, their tallest, that 5'8", actually, who, along with Emily Roy, we haven't seen yet. But a lot of their other players, you'll notice Brianne Chouinard, she's, you know, a bit of a spark plug for them. But, you know, 5'5", unfortunately, when she gets up to that front line, it's, you know, not a match there for those Mohawk Mountaineers.
Yeah, having the definitely when the double block goes up front of the Mountaineers, it's just too much for Boreal to handle right now. They're going to have to find a way to get over that block or position the ball down the line and confuse the Mountaineers' defense.
But we'll just be getting back into action here in just a few moments as the players come out of the huddle. Mohawk again takes that first set 25-16 and that first game there. Boreal coming back on the floor here.
As we pick it up in the second set, for sure. Referees just checking the positioning here, making sure everything's okay. Mountaineers seem okay. He's just checking Boreal now.
So for the Mountaineers, you'll see Mann, Asaf, and Child on the back. And then you'll see Kuiper, Marmo, and it looks like Bialikowski to start for your Mountaineers here. And on the back, we have Mann setting up for the serve. Back in here to the second game. Serve up and over. Dig out there from Phillips, over as Boreal. Sicard got it, but we had our own dig out there and save. Mohawk here.
Kuiper to man to Bialikowski. That's what you want to see, Nick. Your veterans really leading the way for the rookies out there.
Great defense, though, from Phillips on the back end there for Boreal. As you'll see here, another one, Boudreau. Good dig out there. Goulet with that spike, though. Dig out on our own side here.
Man,
big play for Marmo. There you go. That was a good rally to start out here. That, I think, might have been another big rally, and that was the first point here as we get 14.
Yeah, Jessna Marmo, definitely not the biggest hitter, Nick, but right there she showed that she can do more than just the back row.
Man with a serve up and over. Over to Goulet with a big power play there, but couldn't keep it in, as it's going to be Mohawk point there as they jump out to a quick 2-0 lead here. And again, you'll see Mann with the serve. Mohawk tries to dig it out there, but unfortunately, a bit of a miss hit as it will be point over to Boreal. As the Boreal coach on the court here trying to get some key strategy to their players, we'll see Haley Verville setting up for serve here. And a 2-1 lead for Mohawk now. Verville with a nice jump serve there, dig out from Asaf. But Bialikowski, big play there, but unfortunately couldn't keep it in. We touched upon those misplays a little bit here, I think, for Mohawk. If they can just tighten up a little bit on those hits, they'll really run away with this match.
Yeah, as well, we also talked about a bit of serve, but this jump serve here, as you see from Verville, it can be hit or miss, Nick. Yeah. It's very hit or miss, like I said. It's either going to work or it's not, but it seems to be working out for Verville here as Boreal takes a 3-2 lead and leads for the first time.
Yep, Verville with the serve again here. Big one up, Asaf digs it out. Mann sets it up. Kuiper with a big spike, but another dig out there from Goulet as she gets it back herself. Asaf digs it out there, up to Kuiper. Boreal gets it on the back line. Phillips setting it up. Goulet gets it over here. Asaf busy on that back line, but boom, as we get a big hit there. Bialikowski starting strong here with that big power kill.
Yeah, yesterday, Nick, we also looked at not only the duo between Mann and Kuiper, but the duo between Mann and Balachowski. It's very lethal, that front line.
Marmo with the serve. Great dig out from Phillips for Boreal. And they're going to say that was a lift there. Oh, actually a double hit, so it will be point over to Mohawk. As we get Marmo again, setting up here for serve. Using a little bit of her own jump serve there. Phillips with another dig out for Boreal. As Verbo gets it over there, you'll see Sicard. But on the other side here, Kuiper tried the big spike there, but unfortunately couldn't get over to the net, and it will be Boreal point. As we get a substitution here, we'll see Phillips sit down for Boreal, and now Melanie Ledger will come on. As Stephanie Sicard sets it up here for serve, we have a 4-4 tie here. Sicard gets it over, dig out there from Bielachowski. Over to Child, big power hit, but again, couldn't get over the net. Mohawk, they definitely have the power, they just gotta tighten up again on those kills, and they'll see this lead grow, but right now they're actually down 5-4 here, Boreal. Sicard again sets up for serve. Child gets it out. And this time you'll see a successful hit there by Bielachowski. That was a big one as she gets it into the right side this time. And Mohawk will tie this one up now, 5-5. And Bielachowski will take it for serve here. And as she sets up for serve, she gets it over. Mohawk now here. Good dig out there, Pizarro saves it. As Marmo gets it back over here, another dig from Boudreau. Sets it up here, Goulet gets it over. Dig there from Bielachowski. Child saves it there, she couldn't get the spike up. See Ledger set it up for number 17 there, Susie. But Mohawk with another save as we get a great rally here. You'll get Pizarro with a big kill there, actually. So good point for Mohawk there as they take the lead now, 6-5. As you'll
yeah,
hear there.
Pursuer doesn't get a whole lot of playing time, but taking advantage of playing time here, getting those extra kills in, and definitely helping Mohawk to take a 6-5 lead here.
As we got Goulet getting it over there. Zara with another big hit, but a great dig out there from Bergeron. But unfortunately, won't be enough there as Mohawk will get that point, and Bielachowski will be setting up again here for the serve. Another good run here for Bielachowski. She was part of the big run actually in the first game as well for Mohawk that helped stretch that lead. We'll see if she can keep it up here. 7-5 for the Mountaineers. And a bit of a lucky one there.
Right off the tape. That's textbook volleyball serve there, Nick. That's what you want.
It's true. You know, if this was tennis, though, you'd see them maybe apologizing, right? But volleyball, maybe a little more cutthroat on those lucky plays. But Bielachowski up and over again. Good dig out from Phillips on the back, but unfortunately they couldn't corral it there. That'll be one too many hits. Point over to Mohawk. So with that extra, obviously four hits there. For those for those audience members, viewers that want a little background, obviously three is the limit.
A little bit of a substitution there for Boreal. Brienne coming into the game for Susie there.
Yep, as actually you'll see Schwinnard with the dig there. Goulet with a big hit there, but Asaf with the dig for Mohawk. Gets over to Kuiper with a big play, but another good dig out there for Boreal. Mohawk sets it up here again. Pizarro with another one. Oh, that back line of Boreal's busy, as unfortunately Boudreau couldn't get that one though. So it'll be point over to Mohawk, but she was busy on that one. Bielachowski still has the serve here, as we've now stretched this lead 10-5 for the Mountaineers. And there you go, Bielachowski, unfortunately. The run had to end eventually there, as we'll see the point over to Boreal. And Emily Goulet setting up now here for Boreal. See if they can bounce back here from that string of key points for Mohawk. Serves up and over. Asaf digs it out. Sets it up for Pizarro, who's been a beast in the middle right now. Lots of power plays. Another kill there for Pizarro. And Mohawk gets it right back here, as we'll see Kuiper set up for the serve. And a substitution here for Boreal, as we'll see Boudreau come out. And we'll see number three coming in here. But as we set it up here, Kuiper with the serve over, and that's going to be an ace there. As unfortunately, Schwinnard could not get that dig out for Boreal. Kuiper setting up again here for another serve. 12-6 for your Mountaineers. Big serve up. Phillips tries to dig it out there. She does. Verville gets it over to Golette. As Kuiper sets it up here for Child, and she gets the kill down there, as unfortunately the two Boreal players couldn't block that one. Mohawk with a big kill there here, as we'll see Kuiper setting up again for serve. Phillips tries to dig it out here. A little bit of a lucky deflection there as Boreal is able to get it over. But Prezura with another big kill. Booyakasha, she is killing it right now in that middle. And as you touched upon, getting a little more playing time here, it seems, as well, Josh, as they're starting to run away in this second game here. But Kuiper up again, and you'll see another ace there for your Mountaineers as Goulette couldn't dig that one out. And we're going to see a timeout here, actually, now, as Mohawk stretches that lead 15-6.
Yeah, as we talked about earlier, Nick, with Prezura playing a little more playing time, Mohawks may be resting some of their starters here. As we look at take a look at the West Division, Boreal 0-6 on the year. Your Mountaineers being 3-2, sitting comfortably in the middle of the pack there with a very tight West Division for sure.
Yeah, you definitely can tell Boreal up against a tough battle here. But you know, Christiane Boudreau, she is a strong player. You notice there on the back line, she had some great digs. And you know, another key one as well too, Emily Goulette, number 15. She's had a couple kills, but you know, it's definitely rough going here so far as Mohawk seems to have turned it on again. It was by Lachowski. She had that key run there from serve, and now you'll see Kuiper keeping it going as well too.
Yeah, back to Emily Goulette there for a second, coming in with 22 kills on the year and 0.11 hitting percentage on the year as well. Total attacks being 89 on the year, Nick. So definitely getting her chances and trying to capitalize as much as she can. Just not working out for her so far in this set.
But as we set it back up here, Kuiper with the serve. Up and over. And a big ace there coming out of the huddle there. You know the Boreal coach won't be too happy with that one, as Goulette wasn't able to get the dig down there. And big, big service ace by Kuiper as she sets up here again. And that'll stretch the lead down to double digits here. 16-6 for your Mountaineers. And another one. She seems to be targeting Goulette there. As Goulette, another one. Couldn't unfortunately dig that out. And going to get another ace here for Kuiper. So Mohawk up and over again. Kuiper trying to get it to Goulette. But for Goulette's sake there, she had a bit of help there from Schwinard. And we're going to see the point there for Boreal. And as we see here now, Schwinard also setting up for the serve for Boreal.
Wow, big swing on that serve, Nick.
Asaf digs it out here as Kuiper sets up Pizarro, but good dig out there for number 13, Sickard for Boreal. But Mohawk gets it back here now as Childs sets up for the big one there, but we're getting a little bit of a good rally here now. But they'll get that one in there for Boreal. Good rally, but that will be Boreal's point. As we get the serve back here now for Schwinard, we'll see a quick substitution as Courtney Phillips comes back in here for Emily Goulette. And it's now a 17-8 lead for the Mohawk Mountaineers. With the serve up there, Asaf digs it out on the back. Kuiper gets the setup. Man with the spike, but some good digs there. Phillips, she's a big one on the back line there for Boreal. But Child does not matter. She takes that setup and puts it down with a kill there.
Yeah, Kuiper going to man there. Not working out on the first try. Tries it on the other side. No problem for Kinsley Child there. She puts it away.
And we'll see another timeout here with an 18-8 lead for your Mohawk Mountaineers.
Well, Nick, you see here, Mountaineers are up 10 points here. What would you be telling your team if you're Mark Savage for Boreal?
Well, what I would be saying right now is we need more points. This one's starting to get a little bit away from them. And, you know, it's going to be a tough matchup, as you mentioned, up front. Unfortunately, they are outmatched with the height. Mohawk definitely gets a lot of their blocks and a lot of their spikes down. But what I will say, though, is there's a lot of perseverance, particularly Courtney Phillips. I'd like to highlight her, number 10 for Boreal. She's done a great job digging out a lot of Mohawk serves there on that back line. Because Mohawk, they have that power, as you'll notice. Kuiper, you know, by Lachowski, they really know how to get those jump serves working for them. So I'd really like to see, hopefully, some more digs for Boreal, and maybe they can swing it back here with a little more momentum on their side. But as we bring it back in, you'll see Kinsley Child on the end line here, number 7 for your Mountaineers. 18-8 lead still here. And the serve is up. Big out there from big one up there. Marma getting some time on the floor, but that was a
Courtney
good
Phillips
dig.
Phillips again, Nick. Just like you just said, highlighting that. But she's getting some brilliant digs.
Unfortunately, nifty play there. Fortunately for Mohawk, though, Pizarro with another big point there. A nice tip in there where there was no Boreal players. As Kinsley Child sets up again here for the serve. Mohawk now 19-8. Big jump serve again, but just like the highlight, something Josh covered there earlier, that jump serve is hit or miss sometimes, and that one was a little off there as it went into the middle of the net. We'll see point over to Boreal, and we'll see Melanie Leisure with her first serve of the day here. Dig by Marmo. Kuiper setting up man, but unfortunately, we will see a violation there, and it will be point for Mohawk. So Mohawk now at 20. Rebecca Powell, though, coming in here, and she'll be replacing Pizarro. And she'll be getting the serve right away on the back line as well, too, here. Number 3, Rebecca Powell for your Mountaineers. And it's a 29 lead here for those Mountaineers. Powell with the serve up. Dig out from Boreal as she gets it over to Sakara. Sakard, sorry. But it's going to be point Mohawk, as Sakard couldn't keep that kill in.
Yeah, the big thing, too, Nick, with going up for those big kills is you want to get the snap of the wrist straight down so you get it inside that back line there. Just when you don't snap your wrist and you don't get that action, it does tend to float longer and not as powerful.
And you just touched upon there with that wrist action, as you'll notice that serve from Rebecca Powell was a little off there. She unfortunately just couldn't get the form right there on that one. So it'll be point Boreal. Boreal with the serve up. Dig out there from Bialikowski. Marmo with a big serve there. But Chouinard dig it out there for Boreal, but unfortunately they couldn't get it over.
So see Courtney Phillips coming back into the game for Melanie Leisure.
Yeah, I think Boreal coach really knows he needs her up the middle there to get a lot of those digs out. But we'll see it here. Yvonne Mann for the Mountaineers gets the serve up. Phillips with some strong return there. As Sicard couldn't get it past the Mohawk Mountaineers there. A couple big blocks and, oh, Bialikowski getting up on her horse there for that one. That was a big, big, big spike there.
Blasting that.
And we'll see a couple substitutions here. Boudreaux coming back in here, and we'll also see Audrey-Anne Soucy. And coming out will be Chouinard. And LeFleur Brunette for Boreal. But as we see Mann here setting up for the serve on the Mountaineer side, 23-10 lead here. Phillips digs it out here. Vervo sets it up over to Goulette, but a great dig from Asaf as she gets that one up here. And Marmo with a big one, but another good dig out as we have a great rally here. Goulette gets it over. Blocked there from Bialikowski, sorry, and they're gonna let Kuiper say that she was allowed that second hit. But doesn't matter there, as we'll see Boreal snag that one. Actually, no, sorry, it's gonna be Mohawk's point there.
Von Mann serving for the match here.
Yes, 24-10 here. Tries to place it, but unfortunately you'll be out of bounds on that one. Point over to Boreal. But when you're up 24-10, you can afford to place your serves a little more there. And that'll make it now 24-11 for the Mountaineers as we get Haley Vervo setting up here for Boreal. Big jump serve up and over. Nice dig out from Powell. Good one from Goulette. Unfortunately, a little bit of miscommunication there. And there you have it. The Mountaineers snagging that second game here big, 25-11. So when we come back here, the Mountaineers are going to have a chance to take this one in straight sets, but now we're going to hit it over to Ryla Weir for some more inside information. Take it away, Ryla.
Before the game, I was able to talk to the coaches, Matt Schnarr from Mohawk College and Mark Savage from Boreal. Both were saying that they feel more than confident about their girls going into this game, but Mohawk has definitely been dominating over Boreal throughout the first two sets. We'll have to see what else the game holds for us, but so far, it's looking like Mohawk's going to be taking the win today. Yeah.
Well, thank you very much, Ryla, for those insights. And we just want to highlight Amanda Kuiper, number 15 here for your Mountaineers. We got some highlights here. She's been killing in this game. As you'll see, big power kill there. Another one that Josh highlighted as well, too. Had a great game yesterday as well.
Yeah, for sure. Amanda Kuiper there. As we see the duo from Mann to Kuiper right there that we keep talking about. It seems to be a broken record for us here at the desk. But for sure, we have to highlight it. Not just her offense, or not, sorry, not just her smashes, but her serves as well. Amanda Kuiper, just an all-around player. You would not know that she is a first-year player by watching her play this year.
Yeah, that was a big, big point. 25-11, Mohawk took that one. And I just like the highlight. It was actually very close. Boreal had the lead there at 1.54 before we had Bielichowski on her serve take some several points there. And as we highlighted there with Amanda Kuiper, she hopped on as well and really took that game away as they jumped out now to the 2-0 lead here. We'll be going into this third set. And we may see a straight sets win here for your Mohawk Mountaineers. As we see the Boreal coach definitely trying to get his team riled up here.
Yeah,
hopefully they can make
up
a comeback.
The troops for sure.
And we'll see Kristen Bielichowski there. Some laughs. I think the Mohawk team can afford some laughs here. A big, big point there. But again, you don't want to get too ahead of yourself here. We still got another one here to take that straight sets. But this would be a big one, though, for the Mountaineers. If they can take this one, that'll put them at 4-2 with their next match coming up against Redeemer College as well.
As we get set here to take on the third set. Referee just checking positioning.
So for your Mountaineers, you'll see Mann, Marmo, Bielichowski, Kuiper, and then you'll see Asaf. And then on the back, you'll also see Sarah Bate. She hasn't seen too much time in this game, but again, Mohawk up 2-0 here. They're definitely going to try and rotate some of their other players, some of their bench players, and get everyone involved here. But we'll see Boudreau with the serve up here for Boreal as we get this third set underway. Bielichowski right off the get-go, but a good dig out from Boreal there. As they get it back over, Kuiper setting up Marmo. Another good dig out. Boreal playing some good defense here. Asaf gets it to Kuiper. Bielichowski, unfortunately, you give her too many opportunities. You're not going to dig that one out. Boudreau, good effort there, but Bielichowski just too powerful on that
one.
Yeah,
definitely got the better of her there. Seems Kuiper's going more into a setter role early on into this set.
As we get the serve up here from Mann. Boreal with a dig out. Goulet with a power play, but Bielichowski and Kuiper said no there as Asaf digs this one out. Mann sets it up for Marmo. Good block there from Boreal though, as it's gonna be Kuiper there up against a couple of Boreal players, and she gets the better of them there with a nice little tip.
Nick, what we call that ball up there is what we call a party ball. It's where it goes straight up and it's anybody's ball, and first one gets it, first one gets the point.
Yeah, those 50-50 plays, they're key, I think, to successful games as we see a 2-0 lead here. Mann setting up for the serve.
Long serve there, puts it deep in.
Schwinnard gets it out there, though, as Goulet gets it back over for Boreal. We see another setup for Bielichowski, and there you have it. Another big kill there. And that's going to be 3-0 here as Mohawk jumps out to a quick lead. And we see Mann setting up again here for the serve. Bielichowski's just going off here. As we get another dig out there for Schwinnard. Gets it over to Sicard, but unfortunately Sicard can't keep that one in, so it's going to be Mohawk point again.
Timeout Boreal called here.
Hey, he doesn't want to see this one get away too quick, as it is the third set, so 4-0 lead here for the Mountaineers. We'll see that timeout, first one of this set for Boreal. And as we focus in here on the Boreal huddle, you'll see the Boreal coach, Mark Savage, trying to get his team riled up there. Quick timeout on that one. As we highlight Bielichowski again, just a big player here for your Mohawk Mountaineers. And I can only say so many times, using that 5'11 height, really getting up that ladder.
As well, not just Bielichowski, it's also the depth of the Mohawk bench as well, Nick. Not only do we have other players that we can bring in that will bring the hammer and will bring the heat. for Mohawk.
It's true. Justin Marmo, another key player here that has seen a lot of time off the bench, but we see the serve up here from Mann, and another ace for your Mountaineers. Unfortunately for Boreal, Boudreau or Schwinnard couldn't dig that one out. And it's been a hot start here.
Melanie Ledger comes back into the game there. Quick substitution by Boreal.
Yvonne Mann with another serve up
Sixth
here.
Consecutive serve by Mann.
Boudreau gets it out. Boreal up and over as Bajachowski saves it there. A setup for Kuiper. And they're going to say that Kuiper gets the point there on the...
Mann to Kuiper again, Nick. That dynamic duo, brilliant for Mohawk and key to their success.
It's almost like they can read each other's minds with how their ability to work together so successfully on every play. But
totally
Mann
agree.
Here with another serve up just over the net. A dig out there by Melanie Ledger for Boreal as Goulet with a big, big hit. But unfortunately, oh no, she does get that one in there. It will be point Boreal.
Yeah, it did touch a Mohawk player as it went out there.
So they'll break the streak here for Mohawk as it's now 6-1 Boreal. We'll see Haley Verville setting up for the serve here for Boreal. Big jump serve up and over. And unfortunately, we couldn't dig that one out as Sarah Bate missed that. It will be point for Boreal, 6-2 here. And Verville setting up again for the serve. Asaf gets that out as Mann sets it up here for Justin Marmo. And Justin Marmo with a nice play on that one as Schwinnard couldn't dig that one out for Boreal. We'll see it 7-2 here for the Mountaineers.
A little bit of a lucky play there, Nick, just off the tape and rolls down the line. Kind of what you want to aim for when you are a hitter like Justin Marmo. That was a perfect play and got a lucky bounce off that tape.
Substitution here as we see Courtney Phillips in for Sosie as Marmo gets the serve up there and an ace for the Mountaineers. Bit of miscommunication going on there on the Boreal side as it seems the back line just aren't sure who's going to dig that one out. But it's now an 8-2 lead here for your Mountaineers as Justin Marmo sets up for the serve again. Big jump serve there. Schwinnard digs it out, but unfortunately couldn't get it to a Boreal player, and we'll see another point here. Mohawk coming out hot on the serve. 9-2 now. We've only had two players serving so far.
It's really common, Nick, where you see, well, it's not really common, but it's really interesting to see that when those missed serves really do get in, that's what happens.
You know, we touched upon it early on. It's been a tough year so far for Boreal. They are winless, and it's looking like that may continue as Mohawk has jumped out to a 10-2 lead here in this third set. But Marma with a serve there. Nice dig out from Goulet. She tries to get it for Sicard, but Sicard won't be able to get that one in as it's going to be out on Boreal. Another point for your Mountaineers. And we'll see Justin Marmo with another serve here. Let's see if she can tie the streak that was set a little earlier in this set with 6 straight points for Mohawk. And she well with her 6th straight point there. Justin Marmo. Mohawk a 12-2 lead now.
Goodness gracious. We've had two Mountaineers servers, 6 consecutive serves, Nick. Unbelievable. Great start for the Mountaineers here.
Yeah, definitely not what you wanted to see from the Boreal side, but hey. The Mountaineers coming out hot. A little nifty play there from Phillips, though. Good save from Mann as Kuiper sets it up here. Sarah Bate gets it over.
Wow.
And unfortunately, couldn't get Boudreau with the dig there. It'll be point Mohawk. They're coming out hot in this one again.
Sarah Bate, more depth from the Mountaineers. A big hitter. 1.23 kills per set average there, Nick. 16 kills coming into this one. Big hitter for the Mountaineers. 54 total attacks for sure. Just shows you that depth of the Mohawk bench.
13-2 lead, 11-point lead here, and they're coming off another big point last game, 25-11. You know, it was a little more dicey in that first game, obviously 25-16, but they've really turned it on here. It's almost like the first one was a bit of a warm-up as they've really turned it on here in that second one, and now in this third set here, 13-2. It's not looking good for Boreal as Mohawk really, really punching it in here.
Yeah, Mark Savage is definitely going to have to rally the troops here if he's going to have any chance of beating the Mountaineers in this third and final set, Nick.
You can see, obviously, talking a lot of strategy there. I think he's really trying to get the communication better amongst his back line there, as it's been a little lagging, I think, on a lot of those Mountaineer serves. You'll see that front line there of Bialikowski, Kuiper, and, of course, Sarah Bate now. Big front line today for the Mountaineers. And we'll see Justin Marmo with another serve here. And Marmo up and over. Nice jump serve. Goulet digs it out. Verville up for Sicard as Asaf tries to dig it out, and a great save there from Kuiper.
Kuiper there, yeah.
as Phillips gets it over here. Asaf looking to set it up again here, man, getting it up. Sarah Bate gets it over here. As Boreal gets it up here, Sicard, but unfortunately Sicard, lots of power there, lots of height, but she's had some struggles keeping it in there. It will be Mohawk Mountaineers point again. 14-2 now. Jessica Marmo on fire here on the serves. Of course, some great team play too to keep her there. But a nice strong serve there. Goulette wanted to set up but couldn't. Tips it over though as Kuiper gets this to Bielichowski. Big play there, and unfortunately Goulette did save that one with the block, but it landed there. Bielichowski with another strong play.
Yeah, a little bit of miscommunication there, Nick, from Boreal. Going to have to tighten that up if they want to get any chance of coming back in this one.
Nine straight serves now for Marmo. As Verville sets it up here for Sicard, see if she can get it in. She does, but good save from Kuiper. Man gets it up here now. Sarah Bate gets it over.
Wow.
Nice little
hit.
Flat-footed smoke there from Sarah Bate as Asaf gets a nice save there again. Back over to Sarah Bate, but unfortunately she can't get the tip in there. And it will be point Boreal, and they haven't had too many. That's the third one for them this game. And we'll see here now. Stephanie Sicard, 13 for Boreal, setting up here for serve. Good dig from Asaf and gets it to Bielichowski. Miss hit on that one, but doesn't matter. When you're good, you're good. As the Boreal players miss that dig, it's going to be point for Mohawk.
So we see Pursua back in the game.
And now Bielichowski going to be serving here for your Mountaineers. Big serve here. As Boudreaux got that to Sicard with a big hit.
But looks like she reached over the net there, yes. Nick. Bit of a violation there by Boreal. Mohawk takes a 17-3 lead.
Yeah, touching upon those little mistakes from Sicard there on her play. Unfortunately, she's got the power, but just can't keep the ball in or her arm in there. But we'll see another ace from Bielichowski. Mohawk taking a big lead here. It's now 18-3 here for your Mountaineers as Bielichowski sets up again for serve.
Only three servers for the Mountaineers so far, Nick. Three. Very consistent serving from the Mountaineers here in this one.
Verville sets up Melanie Ledger there, but unfortunately Ledger couldn't keep it in. So it will be Mohawk point again. We'll now see Isla Cameron coming in here for Yvonne Mann for the Mountaineers. It'll be the first time we see Isla Cameron today, number 11. Serve here from Bielichowski though. Dig out from Sicard. Marma up. Kuiper over to Sarah Bate. Big hit there from Sarah Bate. And that's what you call a good spike and a good kill right there. As Mohawk gets into the 20s now. 22-3. Big lead here. Bielichowski setting up for serve again. Good dig from Boreal. Sicard sets it up. Unfortunately, though, Melanie Ledger couldn't finish that one. Good block there from Kuiper on the Mohawk side. We'll now see another substitution on the Boreal side, as we'll see Lafleur Brunette in for Christine Boudreau. And Bielichowski just waiting to get this next point in. And here she is with the serve. Good dig there, good save by Verville. As we get a dig here from Bielichowski. Zero with another big hit there. She's been big up the middle for the Mountaineers as she's back in. 22-3 lead here now as Bielichowski is going to be setting up for serve again. Coming down to crunch time here, 22-3. Big serve over. Sicard tries to save it. Ledger does. Back over to Sicard, who just gets it over, but Kuiper was ready for that one as Marmo sets up Sarah Bate there. Good dig out on the back line. Verville getting it over to Goulette, but Goulette could not handle that one, and that was a big miss there. Out of bounds, as we'll see it now, 23-3. Mohawk Mountaineers point there. Bielichowski setting up again here for serve, and as Josh covered, she is only the third Mountaineer to serve here in this set. But Ledger digs it out, but unfortunately, Verville could not set that one up there. I wouldn't be surprised if she was a little intimidated by the Mohawk front line there. Kuiper was right on her. And now we're going to have game point here. 24-3 for your Mountaineers. And Bielichowski, here she goes. As Sicard gets it up, Verville does save it there. But we're going to see Kuiper set it up here for Brazawa. A little tip. Ah, another save. But unfortunately, Mohawk couldn't dig it out there as Boreal will take that point. A little nifty tip in there. And that'll be their fourth point of this set. 24-4 now. As Emily Goulette sets it up here for serve. Good dig by Marmo. Kuiper getting it to Sarah Bate with another very powerful low hit there as Goulette gets it back now, and she's just going to get it in there as Boreal strings together a couple of points here. Goulette with a nice shot there. 24-5 here for Boreal. Or sorry, for Mohawk Mountaineers. But Boreal has the serve here. Goulette up and over. Bajachevsky with the save.
Sarah Bate with those beautiful swings today, Nick. Not a lot of playing time for her, but when she gets it, does she ever take advantage?
True, Sarah Bate has almost that windmill action going. As you'll see, Isla Cameron with a nice shot there, but a good dig by Boreal. Cameron setting it up here as well. Kuiper getting it over. Good dig by Sicard there from Boreal as Verville sets it up for Goulette, and Goulette couldn't get it. And you'll see the win here for your Mohawk Mountaineers, 25-5. A massive win in that last set as they take it in straight sets here over Boreal. Your Mohawk Mountaineers women now 4-2 on the year.
Yeah, just pure domination there, Nick. We're going to throw it to some highlights here after we finish here. As we see Amanda Kuiper here, massive, 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 massive play today.
Look at that emotion that she showed there, too. And you'll see Bialachowski. Mohawk, they had a lot of smiles today because after, again, a little bit of a slow start in that first set, they really took it to Boreal.
And as we talked about earlier in the game, Nick, three servers for Mohawk in that last set. Unheard of. And very uncommon, but great to see by the Mountaineers there. Let's take a look at another serve here. Ace.
Yeah, they had a few aces today. I believe it was 6 in total. So Mohawk definitely, not only were they doing it on the front line with some key power, some key kills, they had some great serving today too. Kuiper, Bialachowski, they were really killing it on that back end.
As the rookie Bate. You never see that very often. That's very uncommon for that to happen. Sarah Bate coming off the bench in the third set and just blasting balls past people.
Definitely,
fantastic.
Definitely, Josh. But now we're going to throw it over to Ryla here. What do you got for us, Ryla?
I'm here with Amanda Kuiper. That was a great game that you played today. Do you feel like coming out of this win is going to prepare you for next week against Redeemer?
Yeah, I think so. We really worked on our systems and got technique down, and we just improved every set, so I think we'll be ready.
Perfect. And do you feel like today you guys played a better game than yesterday, or do you feel like you changed your strategy at all?
I think definitely yesterday was tougher, so today we really had to not sink down to like their level and play our game and really focus on what we needed to do.
Perfect. Thank you so much.
Thanks.
Back to you guys at the desk.
Well, thank you, Ryla. As we get set for the men's action now, we'll be back at around 3 o'clock for the men's game, and we'll see you then.
Yes, thank you, Josh. This has been Nick Sahami. Again, your Mohawk Mountaineers women with a big win. And when we come back, we'll see if the men can continue their domination this year in their undefeated play. 3 p.m., everyone.